The South African Municipal Workers Union says that its members will continue with their protest until Tshwane Mayor Stevens Mokgalapa gives workers a pay increase. Workers affiliated to the union have illegally blockaded various streets in the city using municipal buses. This caused chaos and major traffic disruptions today. The workers claim that senior managers received a salary increase whilst general workers allegedly didn't. Hundreds of workers gathered outside Tshwane House under heavy police guard. Well, for more on this story, we're now joined by our reporter, Molemo Mothoa, who's in Pretoria. Molemo, thanks very much indeed for joining us. Give us the latest of what happened today and what's the situation now.
We are still in the Pretoria CBD, just outside the Tshwane House, where thousands of the Tshwane municipal employees have converged following a strike action where they are demanding a salary hike of 18%. They are actually saying that they demand that hike to be backdated to 2017, as they allege that some of the heads of divisional heads and senior managers have received lump sums of money. They actually are saying that they have been told that there is money, and they are vowing to continue with the strike until each and every one of them receives an SMS in their phones to say that they have been granted that salary hike. And what I can say is that traffic is still chaotic following that strike action earlier in the morning. We know for sure that a number of routes within the CBD were affected, those are including Sisulu Street, Madiba, and as well as WF Ngomo and Eskia Mphahlele. Those are the routes that have been quite affected, and especially coming from the outskirts of the city, coming inside. It has been very chaotic from morning, as some of the motorists had to even drive back to their homes, as it was not easy, or as they could not be able to get into the city center. And we actually have not been able to speak to anyone from the city of Tshwane. That's the officials, as we were told that there was a meeting earlier on between the acting mayor Abel Tau and the SAMWU representatives or SAMWU leadership. We haven't heard any feedback from that meeting, but as it is right now, Peter, not so long ago, where I am standing, if you can just see behind me, there's a number of buses lining up. We have seen also a number of them just a few minutes ago being driven to this place. They actually are some of those that were used earlier to blockade the roads, as well as some of the municipal trucks. And we actually don't know the reason why they have been moved to the places where they had been parked earlier to be parked here, because as we are talking to the Tshwane Metro Police spokesperson earlier, he said they actually were trying everything that they can to ensure that in the afternoon they do not inconvenience passengers, they do not inconvenience motorists, but it doesn't really look like the situation is going to be resolved anytime soon, as we were told that the municipal workers, those who are driving those trucks, those who are driving the buses, have left with the keys, and the municipal officials are actually now struggling to get those keys to be able to move the trucks, or rather to move the buses. Like I say, that we haven't been able to speak to any of the executives from the city of Tshwane, but The MMC for transport, Shilasin Kubuge, was quoted earlier as saying that those who have illegally removed the city property and those that have involved themselves in disrupting service delivery probably are going to have to face disciplinary action. We also understand that there is another meeting that is going to be held around 6 o'clock, between the SAMWU leadership to map the way forward tomorrow.
All right, so Molemo Mothoa, that's where we're going to leave it. That's our reporter, Molemo Mothoa, who's in Pretoria, right at the center of the activity that's been taking place in Pretoria. The city center in particular shut down with these buses blocking roads in protest, saying that they deserve a pay increase and that senior managers were given one and they allegedly weren't, and they're looking for an 18% pay rise. In other news,